Hi, welcome to the video on machine learning interview questions and answers from careerright.com. The use of computers and internet allowed the businesses to store and access the past data. Then they went a step ahead and started using the past data to understand the future trends. This led to an advancement in data science, and soon the machine started getting capable of making the decisions and predictions for us. And with the advancement in technology and the ways to use the available data, the field of machine learning is going to see a tremendous boost. In this video, we get you some commonly asked general, conceptual, and technical questions that may be asked to you also at your interview. So let's begin and stay tuned till the end. Okay, so let's see the first question. What are the different variants of machine learning algorithms? Well, quite a simple and expected question on this subject. To answer this question, you can say, machine learning is a set of algorithms that makes the machines learn the data, predict the trends, and make decisions to be used in various walks of our life. The machine learning models can be divided into three types based on the way they learn. The first one is supervised learning. In supervised learning algorithms, the labeled data, which is also called as input or tagged data, is fed to the algorithm, which is taught what the expected output should be. Here, the algorithm is taught again and again by humans about what a particular data says. These algorithms are useful when all the data is labeled. Supervised learning problems can further be categorized into classification problems, that is when the output variable is a category. And the second one is regression problems, that is when the output variable is a real value. The examples of such models are logistics regression, random forest, nearest neighbors, support vector machines, etc. The second variant of machine learning algorithms is unsupervised learning algorithms. Here, the inputs are fed to the algorithm without telling it the expected output. These algorithms are capable of solving their own problems. Here, the algorithm observes the patterns and structures in the given data and makes its own decisions. These algorithms are useful in cases when the data is not tagged or labeled or divided into the categories. Unsupervised learning problems can be categorized into clustering and association. Some examples of such models are K-means, GMM, PCA, etc. When only some of the data is labeled, while the major portion of it is unlabeled, the algorithms used are semi-supervised. The third variant that we have on the list is reinforcement learning. In reinforcement learning, the algorithm continuously learns from the environment in an iterative process until it has explored the complete range of possibilities. The agent or the algorithm just needs reward feedback to learn and fine-tune its behavior, which is referred to as reinforcement signal. Okay, moving on to question number 2. What are the qualities of a good machine learning code? Well, as a machine learning coder, you will be required to write some code. So this is also a much expected question that you must be prepared to answer. To answer this question, you can say, a machine learning program is expected to work with large amount of data, time and again, even in complex situations. This needs it to possess the following important qualities. And the first one is its scalability. A good machine learning code is capable of being scaled up when the complexity is increased with time. Then there should be no manual checkups required. Since the machines are expected to work on this code, it should not require any human intervention to check which functions and parameters were run together. The third important quality of this code would be that the data that you have used or generated should be automatically saved at the right place. Humans should not be required to keep a record of that. And of course, it should be easy to understand for others. Because other members from your team may need to work on your code to upscale it, fix it, or maximize it. It should be easy for them to read and work on it. Okay? So these are some of the qualities of a good machine learning code that you can talk about in your interview. Moving on to the next question. What is the difference between train data and test data? Well, now this is a technical role. So you must be prepared to answer some technical questions as well. To answer this particular question, you can say, when you want to create a supervised learning algorithm, you use train data and test data sets. Training data set contains both the input and the expected output. It is used to train the algorithm. Testing data set contains just the input and examines how well was the algorithm trained. During the process, you have to be careful that your test data doesn't leak into the train data. Otherwise, while the algorithm might perform very well during the training and testing, it can fail miserably in real life situations. Okay? Moving on to the next question. What are the most popular regression algorithms used in machine learning? The most popular regression algorithms used in machine learning are linear regression, logistic regression, clustering, support vector machines, decision trees, naive bias, etc. Well, while I have just included this question to inform you that this type of a question might also be put to you, it would make sense to be aware of the details of each of these algorithms and other such algorithms as well, because this is one of the most important questions of your interview. Okay? Let's see question number 5. What are the advantages and disadvantages of k-nearest neighbor algorithm? Now, while it is important to know the technical details and working of each algorithm, it is also very important to know the advantages and limitations of each model, so that you can decide if a particular model is favorable to be used in a particular case or not. Talking about the KNN algorithm, its main advantages are, it is very easy to understand and implement, because it works very well with the basic recognition problems. It is non-parametric in nature, so it doesn't require any assumptions to be made and met by the data like other parametric models. And since it tags the new data simply based on the learnings from the historical data and the labels of the nearest neighbors, it doesn't require much training time. It continuously evolves itself with the new data getting into the system. And it works very well with both the regression and the classification problems. So these are some of the advantages of this model. Let's look into the disadvantages now. The biggest disadvantage of this model is its declining speed. As the data grows, the speed declines, and it is not effective with large number of input variables. Choosing the optimal number of neighbors while trying to classify a new entry is another problem that this model faces. If your data inclines towards a particular class, there's a high possibility of getting a new entry classified wrongly with this model. The outliers may also affect the performance of this model, as the classification is based on the distance. The model doesn't learn anything from the training data. It just uses the training data to classify the data in actual situations. And changing the value of k can change the predicted class variable. So these are some of the advantages and disadvantages of KNN model. Prepare yourself to answer this type of a question for other models as well. Now, to check how aware are you about the whole process of coding for the machines, the interviewer might ask you their next question, and it could be, what are the important stages in machine learning lifecycle? To answer this question, you can say, the process of machine learning goes through a set of stages in its lifecycle. They include gathering the data and then preparing it. That is, making it usable for our machine learning algorithm. This data is divided into training data and test data. Cleaning, normalization of data, etc. are a part of this step. And then you choose the right model depending upon your data type. Once you have chosen the model, you start training it. This stage consumes the maximum amount of time, because until and unless you are happy with the model's performance at this stage, you need to readjust it to make the correct predictions. And then you start testing the model. At this stage, you test it with the test data set that you kept aside at the time of splitting the data initially. This data is different from what you used for training the model. Then you start tuning the parameters. This is done to further improve the performance of the model. Here, it is also very important to be alert that you don't land up over-tuning the model or the parameters, because that can lead to a lot of wastage of time and still inaccurate predictions. And once all of this is done, you start making the predictions. This is the outcome of all the hard work that you have put in to make your machines learn to predict in the real world. So, answering this question like this tells the interviewer that you are aware of the whole process of coding for the machines. Okay, let's move on to the next question. What is the difference between classification and regression in machine learning? To be able to solve a prediction problem correctly, it is very important to clearly understand if the problem is that of classification or regression. The biggest difference between the two is the output variable in case of regression is a numerical or continuous, while in case of classification, it is categorical or discrete. So, regression is the task of predicting a continuous quantity, while classification is the task of predicting a discrete class label. Okay, let's see the next question. Now, the next question that we have on our list is a situational question that tests your problem-solving skills. And the question goes something like this. The data files used for machine learning algorithms can be very large at times. How would you handle them to avoid the crashing of algorithms or letting it run out of memory? Well, I always recommend going prepared to answer these situational questions because they test the real metal in you. To answer this particular question, you can say something like, yes, the data sets in machine learning can be really large at times and may lead to problems like crashing of algorithm or the system running out of memory. Following are some of the ways that I use to deal with this problem. And the easiest one is to increase the memory of your computer. If your requirement is heavier, you can even consider renting computer time on cloud services. Then checking the tools or the libraries you are using and trying to reconfigure them to allocate more memory is also useful. One of the very important tips that really works for me is decreasing the data set size to something that I really require. If the system doesn't need that large a data set, why use it? Then you can also try converting your data set to a format that can load it faster or uses lesser memory or maybe doesn't need the complete data set to be loaded into the memory at a time. Progressive loading can help you save the memory tremendously. Then relational databases can be a good way to deal with this problem. But this will need you to use algorithms that support these databases. And if the database is really huge and nothing else works for you, use big data platforms. Question number 9. What is classification accuracy? Classification accuracy is the ratio of correct predictions made by your model to the total predictions. Usually, it is presented in percentage format. The reverse of classification accuracy rate is error rate. The main limitation with the classification accuracy rate is it at times doesn't give you a very clear picture of the performance of your model, especially when your data contains three or more classes or when the number of classes are not even. In these cases, you are not able to understand if the model is working equally well on all the classes or if it is ignoring some particular classes. So, while your accuracy percentage may be high, you can still not be sure about the performance of your model. Question number 10. What is data leakage? How would you prevent it? Now, data leakage is when the model uses data other than the training data while getting created. This usually happens when the validation or test data leaks into the training data. Following are certain things you can do to prevent this. First of all, split your data set into train, validation, and test data. And keep everything other than your train data away. Use it consciously when you are fully done with training the model. Also, avoid over-preparing the data. Otherwise, it may lead to overfitting. Then you can remove all the data you have prior to the event of your interest. If you suspect some variables to be leaking into the model, consider removing them altogether. These are some of the steps you can take to prevent data leakage. Okay, let's move on to question number 11. That is the final question of this video. What do you know about bagging? Bagging or bootstrap aggregation is an ensemble method. Ensemble methods take the predictions from various machine learning algorithms together and make predictions which are expected to be more accurate than any single method. Bagging is used to reduce the variance of high variance algorithms like decision trees and can be used for both classification and regression problems. With this, we come to the end of this video. If you have found it useful, do give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Subscribe to the channel to stay updated with more such editions. If there is a specific topic that you want covered in the interview questions and answers, do let us know by commenting in the box below. We'll try our best to get it to you. Thank you and see you in the next one.